my dad, but love your mom so much. And what is the reason? It's just the vibe of that guy. She wear legs in the sky whenever I pull up. She got her clothes off from the walk. She won't waste no time.
Hey guys, it's T Harris here. If you're returning, welcome back to my channel. And if you're new, thank you for joining us today. I know you are well overdue for an update, and trust me, this is a pretty big update. So I'm gonna set you guys up, because right now I'm holding my tripod and it's heavy, girl. So guys, I am in another new space, but this one is a little bit more permanent this time. I will be here for the next 3 years, and I'm super excited to finally share with my YouTube family where I am now stationed at. So if you've been following for a while, you know that I was originally living in the UK from 2018 until 2021, and then I moved back home to Virginia for a year, and just recently on the 20th I moved with my husband to India. So I am super excited for this new journey, this new chapter. We are here for work, of course, just like when we were living in London. So we will be here again for another 3 years, God willing. I am just over the moon excited. I'm ready to start getting back to traveling and taking more adventures and doing things like that. And this time, so many people have asked me to make sure that I vlog the experience, and I am stepping out of my comfort zone completely and plan on doing just that. So I hope you guys stick around. Hopefully I will be able to get out and about a lot and get a lot of good footage for you guys, and then also just bringing you guys along with me during my daily day-to-day tasks, just to see what I'm up to and things like that. But again, yeah, I'm super excited. Just wanted to kind of give you guys a heads up. I noticed from like my last video about hotel living, a lot of questions were arised about like how much did I spend. So I'm gonna do a separate video on that, just because we aren't in the hotel anymore, obviously. But I still want to answer those questions for people, if they're interested in living in a hotel full time. I'm about to actually head to the grocery store and pick up a few items for the house so that we can start really getting settled in. I pretty much did about, I would say like 80% of the unpacking. I still have like a suitcase and a half to finish unpacking and putting things away. I'll check in with you guys a little bit later. Hey guys, I look absolutely crazy. Please ignore me. My hotel room is in shambles. I know I haven't done an update in so long. I just felt like my days were super repetitive and kind of boring, and it just wasn't content that I wanted to do. But I feel like now I'm in a place where we're gearing up to move in like 2 weeks. You heard me, 2 weeks. We are on our way to India. So that's where we are at. If you could see this room, I might show you. I'm so embarrassed, but I'm not, because I'm trying to get stuff together. We're about to start packing stuff up today to take it to our storage unit, and then tomorrow we're gonna pick up the stuff that we had delivered when we first got here to my in-laws' house. We're gonna pack that stuff up tomorrow and take it to the storage unit, and then next week the people are gonna come and pick up our stuff from the storage unit to be shipped off and flown off to India. I'll show you. So I really haven't packed anything. So this pile right here, I thought I did so well, because this is like the least amount of clothes I've ever taken with me in my suitcase.
and we only get 2 suitcases and the rest of our things don't come for quite a bit of time. I'm trying to decide what shoes I'm taking. I don't know yet. And again, excuse the mess. And then everything pretty much over here is what I had in the room that is going to get more than likely put on the ship because I don't need this stuff anytime soon. I ended up getting a new suitcase. This suitcase is just a medium, smallish size. And I just felt like I didn't want to try to cram everything in this little suitcase. Plus, I have a big suitcase, but I just wanted to be comfortable and I really didn't want to overpack. So I have this that's going in storage. And then I have this little container. It has pretty much like t-shirts and stuff like that. This stuff is probably going to come with me. I just have to organize. So it's not too bad, I don't think. I don't think it's too crazy. Honestly, I think it's... Like I said, clothing wise, I think I've done a great job with packing the amount that I have. So I did order a new large suitcase, so that's supposed to come next Tuesday. We're going to pick up my other large suitcase from our storage unit when we go to drop some stuff off. I'm going to pick that up, bring that back. I'm going to start packing that up. Then the only things I'm worried about, and it's another reason why I ended up getting another large suitcase, is because I have to pack like hair products, facial products, just all those things like toiletry items, things that I know I'm gonna need when we first get there. And I don't know how, I mean, this is a super foreign country to me, so I don't know like the products that they'll have or like when we'll even be able to go to the store. So I want to make sure like I'm comfortable for a good period of time with things that I typically use. So that's another reason why I got another large suitcase, so that I'm able to pack the things that I want and really truly will need within those first few months. Did a better job this time at eliminating clothes, because normally I would pack so many clothes and then I won't even get to wear half of them, or like I wouldn't wear a lot of the pieces often. This time I said no. Plan is to split the clothes in half and do one in one large suitcase, half in the other large suitcase, and then pack like shoes, toiletry items, again probably half and half. I still have to pack my makeup, so that has to go. I don't want to take that in my, I don't know yet. I got this tote, this Marc Jacobs tote, last weekend to take some things like on the plane as my carry-on bag, and I do feel like I might have some room, so I might end up packing my makeup with me. That's what I normally typically do. I typically pack my makeup with me, and then I have another small carry-on, so I use this as my purse and I use my small carry-on as just that, a small carry-on. So what I might do is pack my makeup with me so I don't have to cram it in my suitcases. I think I'm gonna do that. I'm just having my first meal of the day. I'm having a protein shake. I have to fix my nail, so ignore that. Like I said, I have 2 that came off. I'm just having this protein shake by Atkins. It's the caramel kind and it's so good, but I added strawberries to it, almond butter, and some chia seeds, and it's so good. And I didn't know I had dairy, and I'm not supposed to be having dairy right now, but I purchased them, and what are you gonna do? I'm gonna finish figuring this room out, and then I am going to see you guys when we're picking up a U-Haul van. So I'll just take you along so you can see, I guess, us pick up this U-Haul van. So guys, this is our van that we ended up renting. We got a U-Haul van. Jeff has some things from the room. My brother Justin, say hi. Got some things for the room. And yeah, we're about to just pack it up. We'll be right back.
morning. I hope you can see me. We are packing out. As you can see, this big old truck behind me. We're at the storage unit about to finish getting all this stuff boxed and accounted for and then loaded up on this truck. We've been here since like 8:30 a.m. and it's now currently 10:47, and Jeff says there's still a ton more to do. So thought I would give you guys a little update. We are still here. It's 12:28. I just picked up some Popeyes for everyone for lunch. It was three movers. So I got everyone some Popeyes and we just ate, and now I'm just sitting in the car waiting for them to finish packing up everything. We pretty much got everything that we needed from the storage units. And they brought everything down. So now they're just like loading the truck up now. And yeah, I don't know what we're doing for the rest of the day. Probably going back home and just hanging out. I packed all my stuff pretty much yesterday, even though it was kind of pointless for me to do that. But I did want to make sure that I didn't need to send some more stuff into storage, because I did have a lot of stuff, and I feel like I still have a lot of stuff, but I think it'll work because I did end up buying a new suitcase. So I have two large suitcases. They're both 28 inches. I like it because you can pack stuff on both sides of it. So the new one that I got, it was making me a little nervous because it doesn't have a zipper. It only has like a latch that you close. So when I tried to close it yesterday, it like wouldn't close at first, but I had to like maneuver some things around and it closed. So I still have some space in there on the other side. I didn't fill it all the way, but I still have some space, which I think I'm going to put like packing cubes on that side, just because of how the suitcase is made. I think I'll be good though. Like, I think the only things left that I haven't actually packed away are like a few hair care products, like my face wash, and yeah, it's like little bits and bobs and things like that. Nothing too serious, so I think we're okay. Like I said, I'm just sitting here in the car now waiting for them to finish up so that we can leave. So yeah.
very tasty Indian food, and it looks like a lot because they gave us extra of the lamb, but it's fine. It actually worked out. Sorry, it's trash. But yes, it was so good. I will try to list what it was. Let's see, this is called, I think, Lao Mons. It's a lamb dish, like I said. These were like lentils in this really yummy, like, buttery sauce. Sorry, it's like everything is everywhere because they did a really good job at packing everything. This other lamb dish is banjara gosh. And of course, I'm not the best of pronouncing the words. Got garlic naan, dal makhani, that was the lentil dish. Lacha paratha is a type of bread, similar to naan but not naan. The banjara gosh, that was a lamb dish. And then the lao mas, darbadi, was also a lamb dish, and it was so good. Spice, so it was perfect to me. I was craving chai all day, so I made some masala chai tea, as you saw me make. And it's so good. I tried it out yesterday and I made it with water and then added milk, and I didn't like it like that. So today I said, let me just try doing all milk and see if I like it that way. And I love it. It's so good. I used silk almond milk and the vanilla, and I can't remember if the one I have is sweetened or unsweetened, but I did still add a little bit of honey, and it is like perfect. And I topped it off with a little bit more almond milk because when I tasted it, it was a little too sweet. I think I thought I made a lot more than I did. I was hoping to have some more already prepared for tomorrow, but yeah, hopefully tomorrow we will get out of the house and take a little walk in our neighborhood, and I'll take you guys along with me. But I am getting ready to call it a night. I am quite tired, still very much so jet lagged. I feel like I either can't go to sleep, and then when I finally go to sleep, I sleep and then I still wake up like super early in the morning. So tonight I'm gonna try to, like, once I go to sleep, whenever I decide to finally go to sleep, it's Friday also, so I'm not like, oh, I have to go to bed at this time, but I do want to like lay down, get comfortable, because I am quite tired. But I'm gonna enjoy my tea and then try to go to bed.
Whatever I do, 'cause I want she and she and she, and they love them so easy.